Hello guys, I'm standing up here. I'm going to tell you about my story, and the title is The Future of the Present. It was a sunny Sunday. Pinky and Koto were getting bored. They had watched enough observation and had finished their homework school. Then Koto remembered about his remote control car 4 years ago. He quickly ran to the storage room and looked for his car. Pinky also followed him, enjoying the search. As they were looking through the car, Pinky found a dusty and rusty old thing which resembled the remnants of Koto's car. Koto, look what I found! Doesn't this look like my car, Simon? That's why. This looks strange. We are just any buttons here. What, Koto? Don't do anything. Let's take it to Dad and show him. Stand quickly. I wonder what's happening if I press this. Said Koto, touching the buttons and pushed deeply. Jab the button with his finger. They both went dizzy. The only thing they saw now was black and green and black and green. They had sword. Only dragon consciousness was shaping rust outside their eyes. Rubbing their eyes, they were surprised to look at their surroundings. No wonder, it's just because they were in a completely new place. Place is this, Pinky? But you look around crazily. And what is this? They saw a big steel castle and strange machine sticking out. The two of them stood in front of the massive doors, green, blue, and red in color. They didn't know which door to enter. They chose the blue door. The door opened up to a vast desert land. The place was so empty. A second of people. They were only sensible for new visions. They stayed inside the door. How terrible! Koto said to Pinky. There is no greenery here at all. I wonder what place is this? Where have we come?
Tiga.
When Pinky turned her head, she saw a huge shadow cast over them. Hey, monster! Stamer Koto. Both froze in terror for a second and then start to run. The monster cast them in whatever direction they ran. Soon both of them were so tired that they couldn't move anymore. Panting and breathing heavily. They stood in front of the monster, helpless. They looked at it and saw that it was made of junk, electronic waste, and all kinds of garbage. And it's time. Please. Please don't do anything to us, begged Pinky.
Ha 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 ha! I'm the garbage monster, and I was created by you, the humans. You dumped all your waste on the earth, pollute its beauty, threw electronic waste, cut down trees, and created your own concrete jungles. And here I am as the result of all your reckless behavior and carelessness.
Yes, we are ashamed of our behavior, and now we realize the impact of our action and irresponsibility, and our failure to save the earth. Please leave us and let us go. We will share to it that hereafter everyone takes care of our environment and be responsible citizens.
Said Pinky.
Ha 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 ha! That is not enough! How do I believe you save us humans?
Rod the monster.
Please believe us. You won't exploit our nature anymore. We have seen the effect of our action. We have seen the state of the earth in future if we continue to exploit it.
Both begged in chorus. As they were speaking to the monster, a strong air blew and put both of them back to their room.
Said the two, wiping sweat and coming back to reality. Wasn't that very scary, Cotton?
Yeah.
Of course, we shall do something on our path to save our earth. I have an idea. Why don't we take a pledge to help men protect our environment? That's a good idea, Pinky. They both quickly set with a pen and paper and writing their plans. They both of them stood in front of their favorite Ganesha and read aloud their pledge. We, Pinky and Kotu, hereby from this moment on to help save our earth's path. 1. Not using plastic carry bags. 2. Not lightening our surroundings. 3. Planting trees and help make our surroundings greener and cleaner. 4. Not wasting water and trying to save it. 5. Using only eco-friendly goods. Insisting our friends and relatives to follow these methods to help make our surroundings cleaner, greener, and stable. Then, they ran to their friends to tell about their experience and spread their pledge of love. Okay guys, the moral value from the story are: let's take our earth, keep natural resources for the next generation. Okay, maybe just it from me, and the last I say,